My name is Anisha Sunkerneni, and we are in the Elefant Lab at Drexel University. So our lab focuses on neurodegenerative diseases such as Alzheimer's disease or Parkinson's, and we also work with Drosophila, which are fruit flies, in association to these diseases. I'm from San Jose, California, and I came to Drexel University to study biology. I'm a scientist because I think it applies to all different aspects of our lives, and it's a field that's constantly evolving, and there's always more to study, more to learn, and it's also a field where we can collaborate and use the findings that other labs and other groups find to help ourselves, and overall it's just a huge network. I wouldn't say I'm the best at math. You don't really need to do hard calculus in a lab setting, so I can do simple addition, multiplication, and most of the time, that's all I really need. I actually worked in a nursing home all throughout high school, so over there I worked in a particular department that dealt with patients who did get affected by Alzheimer's disease and other neurodegenerative diseases, so I could see firsthand exactly how these diseases impaired them and how it affected them and their daily lives, and how different of a person they could be due to this disease. The short-term outcome of the lab is to learn more about Alzheimer's disease so we can better treat it, so it can help mediate some of the impairments that patients with Alzheimer's disease suffer, such as nerve control and memory deficits. We use microscopes, we use forceps when we dissect, we keep the flies in containers that are either tubes or flasks, just whatever you see in a science class, a lot of the time you end up seeing it in a real lab too. Lab life is not sitting in a dark basement with blacked out windows. As you can see, we have plenty of light. Since we work with fruit flies, a lot of the time we spend time taking care of these flies and making sure they have the food they need, they're alive, they're promoting offspring, and then once we analyze the data, that's when the real research and findings and conclusions can be drawn. If our research turns out to be amazing and we find some amazing breakthrough, I would hope that Alzheimer's patients have less memory deficiencies and they have better control and they can interact with their family and friends in a more normal manner. Sure. I tell the kid next door that they don't need to be good at math, or they don't even need to be particularly great at science right now. There's always room to grow and room to learn, and as long as they have the passion and drive to continue down that path, there's always room for improvement, and there's always space in science for everyone.